celebrated painters in the world. His fascinating universe contributes to the international aura of Belgium. To highlight the importance of this great artist, the Royal Museums of Fine Arts of Belgium have developed a project to create the biggest museum dedicated to the painter. It will be located in Brussels. This ambitious project is supported by the Magritte Foundation and the French-Belgian Suez Group, European leader in the field of energy and the environment. The Magritte Museum will be located at the Place Royale, an exceptional site close to the Grand Place and the Royal Palace. It will occupy one of the premises of the Royal Museums of Fine Arts, offering a unique circuit from the Flemish primitives to contemporary creation. The Magritte Museum will be one of the most important cultural centers of the European capital, with more than 170 works and numerous archives of the painter. It will present the largest Magritte collection in the world. In a refitted building, visitors will be able to discover 5 levels with exhibition rooms, bookshop, and multimedia areas. Suez will put at the disposal of the museum the newest technologies in scenography, lighting, and multimedia equipment. Thanks to these technologies, Magritte's sky will be reflected on the museum's external windows, inviting visitors to discover his mysterious and dreamlike universe. In the entrance hall, the public will be received with a projection of the wall painting, The Enchanted Domain. This work resumes all of the elements of the painter's world. At each floor, visitors will be able to see films which Magritte and his friends produced as amateurs. They will also be able to consult unedited records and documents in a dedicated computer room. Thus, they will be able to discover all the aspects of the painter's creative life. Magritte's paintings will be displayed on 3 levels and in chronological order. All the periods of the painter will be represented. In fact, the visit begins on the 3rd floor with Magritte's first paintings. Showcases containing letters, drawings, and objects will divide the space into alcoves. Each of these, devoted to a specific topic, will also be dedicated to one of Magritte's friends. On the 2nd level, visitors will discover unknown periods of Magritte. In Brussels, during the war, Surrealism en plein soleil, Magritte and communism, the Cow series. The 1st level will recall key moments of the painter's life. Some of his greatest masterpieces will be displayed there. Each work will be shown in the best display conditions in order to make the Magritte Museum one of the most modern and prestigious museums in Europe. The museum will open its doors in Brussels, in the heart of Europe.
Just as an introduction, it was the film who was made at the beginning or at creation, but so you have an idea of the organization in several levels and also the contents of the museum and our approach. So I'm very happy to share the Magritte experience with you today, and I must say that the Magritte Museum is part of the Royal Museums of Fine Arts, as you all understood. So we are at the moment in a phase of redeployment of all our collections, because we have collections dating from the 14th century until today. So these are several ages of collections, and which are distributed in an Old Masters Department, Modern Art Department, which is now reduced, and then very soon we are opening a new museum, the Van de Siecle Museum, which is covering our collections from 1868 till 1914. And then there are 2 other houses, the Wirtz House and the Meunier House, which are the artist houses and workshops of 2 19th century Belgian artists. We have about 700,000 visitors a year, it depends on the years, of course, and a very international important scientific department. So that is the hole in which Magritte is included. So, in fact, now the museum, the Royal Museum of Fine Arts, is really facing a major strategic challenge, which is the redeployment of its collections. And it is our aim to turn the Royal Museums into effective entities. And we would like these entities to be centers of research, but also centers of cultural heritage accessible to all, and also centers of economic development through culture and tourism. So we want it to be a place to conserve the past, but also to explore the future. So the Magritte Museum was the first step in the redeployment, and the Van de Sickle Museum will be the second step in December. So it is important to tell that the Magritte Museum was really the fruit of an original public-private partnership. So it was a fusion of two big collections, the Magritte collection of the Royal Museums of Fine Arts of Belgium and also the collection of the Magritte Foundation. So we fused these two collections in one, which makes us the largest collection of Magritte's work over the world. And another important partner was Suez. You have already understood that from the film. And this was a skills-based sponsorship. I come back to that. And then the Belgian state. We are a federal institute, scientific institute, and we directly depend from the federal government. And the Régie des Bâtiments, who is owning all the federal buildings and restoring them, is also an important partner in this project. So a skills-based sponsorship was really a first for us in Belgium. And for us, it was a relatively new concept. In the meanwhile, I probably think it's already repeated everywhere else in the world. But for us, it was very important at that moment because we got like 4.5 million euros budget, not in money, but in provision of services and experienced staff. So expertise and technology through the sustainable development of its energy supplies division was given by Suez to the museum. And there were two subsidiaries who were included in the project. That was Fabricom, who did the refurbishment of the work inside the building. And there was INEO also for the multimedia portal of the museum collections and the audiovisual and multimedia systems within the building. So, as you see, the Magritte Sky was produced by INEO. Okay. So, we've talked already about the collection. So, we think Magritte, we can call it a success. Why? Because we had so many visitors. That's one of the reasons. We had, since 4 years, more than 4 years now, about 1,600,000 visitors, which means like 400,000 visitors a year. And 60% are foreigners. Magritte can be seen as a very universal artist. Young, old, everybody like and is attracted by Magritte. And we have so many people coming from all over the world. We are so happy we see Japanese, Russian, Chinese, Americans. From all over the world, Magritte is like a very universal figure because he probably uses the everyday life in his paintings, in his works, and at the same time, he makes people dream. So we had several awards, which confirms our success. The Hors Catégorie of Brussels Tourism and Meetings Awards in 2010, the Prix du Musée in 2012, and there we were selected by the public. So we were very happy to have this award by the public who voted for us in 2012. And then the TripAdvisor and Suez got also a prize for best sponsorship by what we call the Prix Caius de Promethea, which is an organization in Belgium. So why this success? We contributed to several things. First of all, the uniqueness of the museum's multidisciplinary collection. Then the museum scenography, which is respectful of Magritte's works. We have tried to have a good balance between multimedia and between the real works, because we don't want the people to get stuck on screens. We want them to watch really and experience the Magritte work directly. So it was a work of balance. And then we have also an ambitious lending program and a dynamic exhibition policy, a wide range of public programs and activities, and modern educational multimedia facilities. But something about the ambitious lending program. So there are a lot of loans from private and public collections and institutions, also from San Francisco MoMA, New York MoMA, the Menil collection in Houston. So a lot of people loan works, which permits us to have a dynamic exhibition policy. And so in 2012, we did a little exhibition, René Magritte, newly discovered works, works we didn't know up till then. And it was in brought down in a catalog, Raisonné, by Sarah Whitfield. And we discovered that René Magritte was also drawing erotic drawings, up till now unknown for the public. So in 2013, right now, there is an exhibition in America, in the MoMA, about Magritte, about his important years, 1926 until 1938. And so for us, it's the occasion to show other works or to show Magritte in the context of the international surrealism. And we took a lot of works of Miró, Tanguy, Delvaux, all these surrealist artists, and we put them at the place as the Magritte works. So we really try to make it a living museum. So that's the exhibition in MoMA. It opened on Tuesday. So, and one of the other important things for us at the creation of the Magritte Museum was the fact of creating an online research center. So the central concern of the museum is to develop research, a research around the figure of Magritte in this case. So it disposes, since the creation, of an online research center with the ambition of becoming the key reference for the study of the oeuvre, life and vision of René Magritte. And its major aim is to give an online access to all the artworks, records and publications concerning the painter and surrealism. So together with ENO, a meta search engine was developed that enables to consult different databases simultaneously. So it's not necessary to come to Brussels, you can really enjoy the Magritte work from all over the world. And only one request about René Magritte shows, for instance, at the same time, the works he has produced, the archive documents and the publications concerning him, or the films he has made. I really consult you to watch his films, they are wonderful, they are really great. And another aspect, and that's the aspect why we probably won the prize in 2012 by the public, is that we really want to be a museum for everyone. So in 2008, we already got another museum prize by the jury. Then we were not chosen by the public, but by the jury, also for our public services policy. So as you see here, we have a lot of groups, but also the queen, our ex-queen, which is not the queen anymore. VIP persons are of course also welcome, but also the homeless. We have several programs, social programs developed by our educational department. And we have also a lot of emphasis on the accessibility. And here you see a relief, a drawing in relief for visually impaired people. And of course, the children and the young public is fond of Magritte. So we have all kinds of activities, as you have in your museums, like guided visiting, workshops for schools, groups, young people and adults, but also special events like family days, teachers' days, holiday workshops for kids and teens, and lectures. And we also develop, for instance, a conference lectures with the university, the ULB, the Université Libre de Bruxelles. So then students can develop the study on Magritte, and we invite always very important persons, researchers to these conferences. And then we have the Museums to Measures programs and projects. Also, we are very concerned by a qualitative approach. And how do we try to do that? We engage quite a lot of native speaking guides in 8 different languages. Because before we already had native speaking guides in different languages, but Magritte was such a success internationally that we had to decide also to engage Japanese speakers, Russian speakers, and Greek. So Japan, also Spanish and Italian, but that we had already before. So we had to enlarge this because it's very difficult for to translate, for instance, into Japanese the concepts of Magritte. So we prefer to work with native speakers. And for the individual visitors, there is a free multilingual quotes booklet with all the quotes of Magritte, which is given at the entrance. And not to disturb the individual visitor, we have a U guide, which is a microsystem for the group, the guide who leads the groups, so that they do not disturb the individual visitor. So then we have also the latest in multilingual audio guides in French, English, German, Spanish, and since 2 years or 1 year, Italian. And it connects sound archives with documentary to enhance the visitor's experience. So we have also Magritte Shop. On Magritte Shop, where you have, of course, all the catalogs and the guides, but also quite a lot of gadgets and a children's corner. Why do I speak about the shop? Because the shop is also an important source of income for the Magritte Museum, but also for the educational department. So it's a policy of the management to give part of the income of the museum shop to support the educational department. One of the things we were able to create, it was a long dream of the educational department, was a Magritte studio. And the Magritte studio is very multimedia, so you can do photography, but also film. You can create, so there are a lot of creative material, books also in several languages, CD-ROMs, a space which is very well developed, and which gives a lot of very nice creative productions and artworks. So I took some with me. So the little boxes. So this is the material. Another thing we could develop thanks to the boost of the Magritte Museum were the teaching tools. We already had teacher packs before, but we created an interactive website. An interactive website in 3 languages and destined to the teachers, pupils, and the family public. And there you can find quite a lot of information, of course, about Magritte, but also a series of creative and interactive games which the people can do before coming to the museum or after having visiting the museum. It's also a platform. It's not only a pedagogical instrument, but also a platform where young people, teachers, families, they can communicate with each other, put their projects on there, and talk about their findings of the Magritte Museum. And we also insist that the Magritte or the visit to the museum in general shouldn't be one shot. So we insist that the teachers should prepare at school, or we go to the social associations who visit our museum with the Magritte suitcase. So we have a suitcase with all kinds of objects and games, and so we can prepare the visit. And in an ideal situation, we invite them afterwards for a workshop. But then it depends, of course, on the budget of the school, if they can do that. But most of the time, it's really a very important thing that they have the whole, that it's not just one-shot experience. So these are still some. Voilà. What we also think is very important is the participation of the public. Our museum, we want people to not only to come and visit, but to recreate, to reinterpret the work of Magritte. And so we started up several projects, especially with the young public, who, as you know, is very difficult to reach, the young individual public. So we worked with young public associations like Amusez-vous, which is a gathering a lot of young people, and they had a holiday workshop in our museum, and they made this magazine here, the René, Prenez le René, Né ma mai, and they wrote the text, they took the pictures, they reinterpreted it in a magazine, and they even interviewed the guardian. So there was a good way of interaction. Oh, I'm already, okay. A good interaction with the work of Magritte, but they had this magazine, which was handed for free for 3 months to all secondary schools who came to the museum. So to show that there was really a lot of material to work on. And then we had another project with the young public, Magritte.me, and there was also during the holidays a multimedia creative workshop, and the result was an exhibition. And that exhibition was integrated in the Magritte Museum itself, and so people could watch the creations of these young people. Let's see the results. I go a little bit further. So then we have all these programs and projects for minority groups, but I also, I always said that there is a lot of emphasis on the accessibility, also of the infrastructure. And we have our visual guide. The visual guide, so the hearing impaired person or deaf person can visit the museum with a visual guide. I got the tablet with me, so if people want to see it, I can show it to you how it works. And 21 works of Magritte are explained in English, French, and Dutch sign language. So we have also the quotes leaflet or brochure, which is translated in Braille and large print edition. So these are one of the some of the examples I wanted to give. And then we had another project, a 5-year project with GDF Suez for the socially excluded persons. And we already worked 1 year with young social young public and social associations. They discovered surrealism through cinema and photography, and also their creations were shown in an exhibition, and here you see them at work. Then we have also René Generations. There were like a whole series of intergenerational meetings in the Marolles, which is a disadvantaged neighborhood of Brussels. And there were also visits to the museum, but also workshops with theater objects. And we made a photography publication, which I also took with me if you are interested. And it was a very nice experience because, for instance, here, an elderly person said, in the museum, I was very surprised to see that the children were really interested for children of that age. I had not been in contact with children for a long time. So which means that the museum becomes really a meeting place. I think it's very important to stress that. We have to make more and more the museum of a meeting place of several generations, but of several cultures, as you already said this morning in the conferences. So this is one of the pictures. So the Magritte experience. It says that that it's very important to have a lot of partnerships. If not, you cannot realize what you want to realize. And there are also a lot of possibilities for the development of scientific research, and also the increasing role of the public and the need for a responsive museum. We have to respond to the needs of our publics. So the mission is to honor the public, all the public, by developing specific strategies which link science, economics, culture, and entertainment. Each project has to include reflection on our contemporary identity while maintaining the capacity of dreaming. And I hope we can still dream about a lot of other new projects together today and tomorrow. Thank you.
Thank you.